In this video, I am going to show you how to visualize the high frequency crosstalk between signals on this simple Arduino board. After that, I will show you some ways on how to reduce the crosstalk. If you're new to this channel and don't have openEMS installed yet, check out the YouTube link in the description in which I show you how to install all the needed apps. All the apps that I'm using in this video are absolutely free, even for commercial use. Let's now start with the simulation process. You can download the KiCad file that I'm using from the link in the description. We will inject the step function into the power supply line, and then we will check how the H field or magnetic field is progressing through this board. If you want to simulate the crosstalk for different frequencies, you have a lot of options. For example, you could inject a sine wave or also a Gaussian signal. Anyway, in this video, I will just use the step function. If you subscribe, you will be notified once I also use the other injection methods. Let's now start with the simulation process. As first step, let's open FreeCAD 0.19. Now let's open the FreeCAD to openEMS macro. Once again, if you're new to this channel, the YouTube installation tutorial video is in the description. Sadly, the first time that you open the macro, the import from KiCad button is grayed out. Simply restart the macro and the button will be enabled. Now check this checkmark and let's import the KiCad file. Once the import is finished, the report view will show an all done message. Now switch back to the main window of FreeCAD. Expand the copper fuse object. Mark these two items. Copy them. And paste them outside of the copper fuse object. Now change to the part workbench. And click on Union. After the union is created, make a simple copy of it. Now mark the PCB object and create a simple copy of it as well. Delete all other objects, so we end up with just these two parts. Let's now create an air box. I will make it 1 mm larger than the PCB in every direction. I will just rename the copper object to copper and rename the PCB to FR4. Let's now mark all objects and set the transparency to 90% so that we can have a look inside the components. Now make another copy of the air box and call the new box field. This will be later used as our magnetic field probe. I will make it 0.1 mm thick, as I just want to measure the cross section of the field. You could also just keep it the same size as the air box in order to get a three-dimensional field around the PCB. I will just increase the height of the air box by another millimeter so that the field probe can fit. Then I will add another field probe between the top and bottom layer and also one below the PCB. The next step is to insert an injection port. I will inject the step function here between the ground pad and the VCC pad. You can change the copper and PCB thickness in KiCad like this. The import tool will import the PCB based on the layer stack information of the KiCad file. We are now done with our component placement. Let's go back to the FreeCAD to openEMS macro and work through the tabs. We will skip the first tab. Let's go to the grid tab and create the grid. In the materials tab, I will add air and FR4. PEC means perfect electric conductor and will be used for our copper. In the excitation tab, we will add the step function. In the port settings tab, the excitation direction is important. We have to inject in X direction. As we apply a field instead of a voltage, here is a hint on what value you would have to insert into this field. We will skip the lumped part tab. You could use it if you would, for example, want to define resistors, capacitors, or inductors. In the probe tab, we can define many different probes, like voltage, current, electric field, H field, and also J field, which we can use to measure the surface current. You can create plots in time domain as well as in frequency domain. But be aware, this is an open source tool, and as in many cases, it is full of bugs. So often you will have to edit the generated code to fix errors. Let's now adjust the simulation parameters. I will only simulate the first 20,000 steps. We will set the whole outer boundary of the simulation as PML, which means perfectly matched layer. What it does in simple words is to make all signals pass through it without reflections, and hence it tries to mimic an extension into infinity. Let's now assign all the parts and generate the code. Before we run the generated Python script, let's first open it and edit some things. As the step function is not correctly generated, let's add it ourselves. And let's reduce the height of the field probes to zero. This is just because I don't know a way yet how to easily create a perfectly flat 2D object in FreeCAD. Let's run the Python script. After a few seconds, a 3D preview should appear. Once we close the preview, the simulation will start. If it crashes with this error message, it means you didn't save the FreeCAD project. Both the settings file and the FreeCAD file have to be saved in the same folder. Once the first two samples were calculated, you can preview them in Paraview. For this, go to the output folder and type in Paraview into this field. Once you click open, you will be redirected into the correct folder right away. I will just open one of the fields. Change the color representation to H field. You can use this button to change the color range. Let's also import our traces. And scale them down by 1000, so they have the correct size. Now make the H field slightly transparent. As you see, the H field is not well contained and we see a lot of crosstalk. So what can we do to reduce the crosstalk? I would do a full redesign, but for that you have to know what you're doing. So before that, let's try some simple things first. If you look at the injection point, you see that the VCC line passes under this track, but there is no return current via. For a two-layer PCB, the best layout style with the lowest possible emissions looks like this. Every single signal should have a return current via on every side of it whenever another signal passes under it. And this is how it should look like if only two signals cross. Sadly, this is often not possible because the PCB size is too small, but then at least use this layout style for all high frequency and analog signals. Without moving things around, the only place I can add a via is here. I already know that this is not good for the RXI line, but anyway, let's proceed. Here are two more crossings that should have received a via, but at least I added some vias here. Let's have a look at the results. Well, as you can see, it helped a bit, but it's not really a game changer. So what else can we do? Let's try via stitching every free point of the PCB without using our brain too much, or simply out of hopelessness. This reminds me of my first years at work, and I know that this never really helped, so I guess this time it won't be any different. Well, again, it helped maybe a bit, but still kind of useless. So what else can we do? The distance between top and bottom layer is 1.5 millimeters. Simply by changing to a 4-layer board and filling the two inner layers with ground, we can reduce the distance to 0.2 millimeters. So the ground plane would be almost 8 times closer than with the 2-layer version of the PCB. But be aware, without rearranging the whole design, there are still some signal transitions from top to bottom without vias for the return current. Even without the simulation, I know that these signals will pick up some noise, and we will be able to verify that in a bit. And also, there are still some signals that don't have a ground next to them. Let's now compare the H field above the PCB for all the versions. As you see, we have some improvement, but hey, this can be much better. In the next videos, I'm going to show you how to improve that by a big margin.